Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I hope you guys are doing absolutely fine. So today is day 9 and the topic for the day is recursion. So first of all, we will understand what is the recursion. So recursion is when a function calls itself again and again until the base condition does not satisfy, and when the base condition satisfy, then it stops calling itself and then it will return the value to its previously calling function. So today we have the task that we have a positive integer n and we just need to find the factorial of that integer. So this is a simple. There is a note also that if you fail to use recursion or fail to name your recursion function factorial, you will get a score of 0. That means there must be a function which name must be a factorial in the program. So okay, our constants are 2 to 12. Okay, so these are the samples and the explanation. If you want, you can pause the video. So as you can see, we already have a function named factorial, so we just need to complete this function. So here we will first of all create the base case. So the base case is when the function does not call any other function. That means it will return a value, specific value. So we will type if n equal to 1, then it will return 1. Because it is given in the question, 1 for n is less than or equal to 1. We are not taking 0 because we have the constant from 2 to 12. That's why. Otherwise, that means in the else case, we will call the function factorial. So in this case, what we will do, we will just type n into factorial and the value will be passed n minus 1, because for the factorial we just need to do that and we will return this value. So here as you can see, I have just typed return n into factorial of n minus 1. I have done this because when we find the factorial of a number, we just multiply the number by the factorial of 1 less than that number. So I have typed n, that number, into factorial of n minus 1. That means the number 1 less than to that number. So for example, we have taken 3 as the n. So here we will just find 3 into factorial of 2. Then when we call the factorial of 2, then it will find 2 into factorial of 1. And when it will be 1, it will return 1. So 1 will be multiplied with 2, and now 2 into 1 will be 2. And this will be multiplied with 3, so then it will be 6. So our answer will be 6. So this is the simple one. Now we will just run the code. So as you can see, it is showing congratulations. Now we will submit it. So as you can see, it has passed all the test cases. So congratulations, and for the next challenge, okay. So that's it for the video guys. If you like the video, then don't forget to hit the like button. If you are new to the channel, get yourself subscribed and hit the bell icon for the notifications. Thank you for watching. This is Sachin signing off.